Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can include links and images on our web pages using HTML. Let's get into it. So before we begin this lesson, you'll want to be sure to download a couple images, I would say four for good measure, and place them within the same folder that has your HTML file that you're going to be working with. So feel free to pause the video now and go and download a few images. To include links and images on our web pages, we first need to discuss attributes. All elements in HTML have attributes. Attributes provide additional information about an element that contains an attribute. They are used in the opening tags of an element and come in name-value pairs. So attributes are useful because we can provide links to web pages, we can include images, and even specify the styling of an element, but we'll save that part for CSS. So let's begin by creating an HTML link. So HTML links are defined with the A tag, and then you also need a closing tag for this as well. The next step is that we'll need some text to function as the link. So for example, let's say that we want to create a link that will take us to Google's homepage. Well, let's write some text that will actually take us there if we click on it. So we can say something such as, if you click on this, you will go to Google's homepage. Let's save this and refresh the page. All right, so currently this doesn't do anything if you click on it. So we need to give an attribute to the A tag that surrounds what's going to be our link. What the A tag does is that any text surrounded with a pair of A tags will function as a hyperlink that can link this text to another web page that you specify, but we need to specify what web page we want to link this to, and we can do that with the href attribute. So within the A opening tag, what we're going to do is type in href, and that's an acronym for hypertext reference. And we set this equal to whatever website we want to link this hyperlink to, and make sure to put this within double quotes. And within the double quotes, type in the address of the web page that you want this hyperlink to take you to. So it usually begins with HTTP or HTTPS, make sure you get it right, then colon, two forward slashes, www dot, and then whatever the URL is for the web page they want to link this to. So if you want to link this to Google's homepage, we're going to type google.com. Let's save this. No, I don't want to purchase Sublime Text. Refresh the page, and then you can see that our hyperlink is now blue and underlined. And if we click on this, it will now bring us to Google when we click on it. Let's say that you want to change this hyperlink so that it opens a new window for you or a new tab instead of just going to the web page directly on the tab that you're currently on. Well, there's an attribute for that, and it's the target attribute. So within the A tag, the opening A tag, we're going to type target equals underscore blank. Let's save it, refresh the page, then we'll click on this, and this will open in a new tab then, or a new window. It really depends on the web browser that you're using. All right, so up next, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a download link. So it's going to be the same process as before, but there's one more thing we need to add. So let me add a few line breaks just to give us some room. All right, so we'll need some sort of text to act as the link. So I will say, download a meme. Let's download a meme. And then we need to surround this with A tags. So we need an opening tag and a closing tag. And then within the opening tag, we're going to say href equals, then double quotes. Okay, so you can either put the address of whatever you want to download within double quotes. If it's a file on your computer, you could put the file path here. Or if it's a like file or a picture within the same folder of the HTML file, you can just put the file name here. Well, I have a picture that's within the same folder as my HTML file, so I'll just put the name of the file here. So feel free to pause the video if you want to download your own picture. So the file that I have named was meme.jpg. So make sure that's within the A tag. href equals whatever the name or the location of your file is within double quotes. And the next important step is to write the word download right after. All right, so let's save this, refresh the page. So it says download a meme. Then if we click on this, it's going to download the picture that I had. So this word download within the A tag is another attribute. So this is the name and you can give it a value and make sure to write this within double quotes as well. So this is the name of the file when it's downloaded and you can name this whatever you want. So when somebody downloads your file, it's going to have this file name, whatever is within double quotes. All right, so that's enough for links in HTML. Let's move on to including images. So I'm going to add a few line breaks just to give us some room. All right, so there's a tag that we need to use to add a picture to our webpage. It is the Img tag, and this is a self-closing tag, so you don't need to add a closing tag to this. So within the Img tag, you're going to type in src, which is short for source, then equals, then within double quotes, wherever this file is located. This can be a web address, this can be a file path on your computer, or if it's simply within the same folder of your HTML file, you can just write the name of the file here. So since the picture that I want to include is within the same folder as this HTML file, I'm just going to put the file name here. So I think this was named meme2.jpg. Let's save this, refresh the page. All right, here's the picture, but it's fairly massive. So there's actually a height and width attribute that we can include within the img tag to adjust the height and the width. So we'll adjust the height first. So we could say height equals, how about 250, and width equals 250. And these are within pixels. So let's save this, refresh the page. And you can see that it's a lot smaller and it now fits on the page. So one thing you might have noticed with this image is that it's fairly stretched, and there's one way we can actually avoid that. With the height and the width attributes, instead of placing pixels as the values, we can actually place a percentage here. For example, we could say height equals 50% or some other number, and we'll do the same thing with width. So let's save this and refresh the page, and our image is no longer stretched. So there's one other attribute that we can add to our image tag. It is the alt attribute. It's short for alternate. For some reason, if we can't display this image, we can display some alternate text. For example, if we can't display this image, the text, "This is a meme," would appear, or whatever text we place within here. So for example, let's say I get this file extension wrong, and we'll say like XYZ, which doesn't exist here. So we'll save this, refresh the page, and it says with this alternate text, "This is a meme." But if we go back and save this, "This is a meme" doesn't display, or whatever else we put for our alternate text. So this is useful if for some reason somebody can't display an image. There'll be some alternate text that lets the user know what normally should be here. So just an important note with this height and width attribute for our image, it will actually resize depending on the size of the window it's currently in. So that's one advantage to using percentages for the height and width attributes. All right guys, so up next, I'm going to show you guys how we can include an image that's somewhere else on your computer and not necessarily within the same folder as your HTML file. So what I'll do is actually copy this and paste it right underneath. And this is meme 3 and it's located on my desktop. So we're going to put meme 3 here. And what I'll need to do is find the file path for this. So I can just right click this, go to properties, and copy this location, this file path. All right, then I will put that within the source. So this is the file path for this. Then I just need to add a backslash, save this. And then let's refresh the page. There's the image that I was looking for. Let's include another image, but this time it's going to be a website URL. So we're going to make a image tag. And the source is going to be this, or find a picture online that you want to place here. You don't necessarily need to copy this. And then I'll set the height to perhaps 50% as well to match the others. Same with the width. And I'll set an alt. You don't necessarily need to. This is another meme. All right, let's save this. Let's refresh the page. And here is our last image. Alright, so to finish up this video, I'll show you guys a cool trick of how we can have an image also function as a hyperlink when we click on it. So it's going to combine both things that we learned about in this video. So the first thing that we'll need to do is to include an image. So we'll use the image tag, and we need to set a source equals, then within double quotes, wherever this file or image is located. So for me, this last image that I want to use is within the same folder as my HTML file, and it's simply named meme4.jpg. And I will also set a height and width attribute. So we'll set this to 50% just to match the others. And we don't need to add an alt, but we can. And this is actually a picture of Gandalf from Lord of the Rings, but I misspelled it. All right, we're good. All right, so let's save this, refresh the page, and here's our last image. All right, now if we want to make this a hyperlink, we have to surround this with an A tag, a pair of A tags like we did for our links at the top of the page. So we're going to put this around our image. So we'll put the opening tag before the image and the closing tag after the image. And we need to use the href attribute within the opening A tag, and we will set a destination for our hyperlink to bring us to. And you can set this for wherever you want, but I think I want this to bring us to the Wikipedia page for the Lord of the Rings. So let's save this, refresh the page. And if I were to click on this image, you can see that the cursor is now a pointer finger when we hover over the image. And if we click on this, it will bring us to the Wikipedia page for the Lord of the Rings. And remember, if you want this hyperlink to open in a new window or tab within the A tag, you just use the target attribute, set it equal to underscore blank. And this will open in a new tab or window. Well, that will conclude the end of this lesson. Hopefully you found this video useful, and that will conclude this topic on using links and images in HTML. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.